Hello students, I welcome you all. This is Dr. A.Y. Khan from Dharwad. Today, we'll be dealing with the chapter Theory of Dilute Solutions. In this chapter, we'll be dealing with some concepts related to solubility of a gas in a solution of liquid in liquid. We'll be dealing with colligative properties like lowering of vapor pressure, relative lowering of vapor pressure, osmotic pressure. We'll be dealing with depression in freezing point as well as elevation in boiling point. We'll also be dealing with ideal solutions, non-ideal solutions, non-ideal solutions with positive deviation as well as non-ideal solution with negative deviations from the Rod's law. We'll be also dealing with the Van't-Hoff's factor. As per your CET is concerned, this is one of the important chapters. Student, let us discuss the solubility of a gas in a liquid. The solubility of a gas in a liquid depends upon various factors like nature of solute and solvent. It depends upon the temperature as well as it depends upon the pressure. Nature of solute and solvent. Gases like HCl, ammonia are more soluble in polar solvent like water as compared to gases like oxygen and nitrogen. Effect of temperature. The solubility of a gas in a liquid decreases with increase in temperature because the solubility of a gas in a liquid is an exothermic process. According to the Le Chatelier's principle, if you increase the temperature, the equilibrium shifts towards the endothermic side, hence the solubility decreases with increase in temperature. The most important factor that influences the solubility of a gas in liquid is pressure. And the relation between the pressure and the solubility of a gas was given by Henry, which we refer it as Henry's law. And the Henry's law goes like this. According to Henry's law, the partial pressure of a gas above the surface of the liquid is directly proportional to mole fraction of the gas in the solution. Hence, partial pressure of the gas is equal to KH into mole fraction of the gas, where KH is called as Henry's constant. Students, let us discuss Rod's law for binary solution of volatile liquids in which both solute and solvent are volatile. According to Rod's law, in a binary solution, partial pressure of a component is equal to the mole fraction of that component into the vapor pressure of that component in its pure form. Let us consider a binary liquid containing two components A and B. Let the number of moles of A be equal to NA, let the number of moles of B equal to NB. Then partial pressure of A is equal to mole fraction of A into vapor pressure of A in its pure form. Mole fraction is given as number of moles of that component divided by total number of moles. Hence mole fraction of A will be equal to number of moles of A divided by total number of moles, that is number of moles of A plus number of moles of B into pressure of vapor pressure of A in its pure form. Similarly, for component B, partial pressure of B is equal to mole fraction of B into vapor pressure of B in its pure form. If both the components A and B behave ideally, then the total pressure can be given by Dalton's law as P total or total pressure is equal to partial pressure of component A plus the partial pressure of component B. Students, let us solve a question related to the solubility of nitrogen. The question goes like this. 5.5 milligram of nitrogen gas dissolves in 180 gram of water at 273 Kelvin and at 1 atmosphere pressure due to nitrogen. the mole fraction of nitrogen in 180 gram of water at 5 atmosphere nitrogen pressure is approximately? Your options are option A, 1 into 10 to the power minus 5, option B, 1 into 10 to the power minus 4, option C, 1 into 10 to the power minus 6, and option D, 1 into 10 to the power minus 3. Friends, we know that solubility of a gas or the amount of a gas dissolved in a liquid depends upon its pressure. They have given that 5.5 milligram of nitrogen gas dissolves at 1 atmosphere. We need to find the mole fraction of nitrogen at 5 atmosphere. If 5.5 milligram of a nitrogen gas dissolves at 1 atmosphere, then at 5 atmosphere, the amount of gas dissolved will be more than 5.5, because the solubility of a gas depends upon its pressure. Hence, the nitrogen dissolved will be 5 times what it dissolved at 1 atmosphere. So it will be 5 into 5.5 milligram. That will be equal to 27.5 milligram. But they have not asked us the amount of nitrogen dissolved. In fact, they have asked us to find the mole fraction of nitrogen that is present. Mole fraction of nitrogen is given as number of moles of nitrogen divided by the total number of moles. I mean, number of moles of nitrogen plus the number of moles of water. That will be equal to. And you know that number of moles is given by mass divided by its molar mass. So mass of nitrogen is 27.5 milligram. That will be 27.5 into 10 to the power minus 3, because we have converted into gram, divided by its molecular mass. Molecular mass of nitrogen is 28, divided by number of moles of nitrogen. That is again 27.5 into 10 to the power minus 3, divided by 28, plus number of moles of water. So 180 gram of water is given. So number of moles of water is equal to mass of water divided by its molar mass. That will be equal to 180 divided by 18, because the molar mass of water is 18. If you divide these two terms, the value will be negligible as compared to this. Here the value will be equal to 10. If you divide these two terms, so the value will be negligible as compared to 10. So you can neglect this. So hence, this will be further equal to 27.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 28 whole divided by 10. 27.5 and 28, this will be nearly equal to 1. This will be nearly equal to 1. Hence, you can write it as 10 to the power minus 3. If I take it to the numerator side, it will be 10 to the power minus 1. Hence, the value will be approximately equal to 10 to the power minus 4. Hence, option B is the right answer. Friends, let's move on with the next question. The vapor pressure of two liquids P and Q are 80 and 60 torr respectively. The total vapor pressure of the solution obtained by mixing 3 mole of P and 2 mole of Q would be option A, 72 torr, option B, 140 torr, option C, 68 torr, and option D, 20 torr. So we need to find the total pressure that is obtained by mixing 3 moles of P and 2 moles of Q. Hence, the total pressure P total will be equal to partial pressure of Q plus the partial pressure of P. That is, partial pressure of P plus partial pressure of Q will give you the total pressure. And partial pressure of a component in a binary solution can be obtained from the Raoult's law. According to Raoult's law, partial pressure of Q will be equal to mole fraction of Q into vapor pressure of Q in its pure form, and partial pressure of P will be equal to mole fraction of P into vapor pressure of P in its pure form, vapor pressure of P in its pure form. As you all know that mole fraction is number of moles of that component divided by the total number of moles. So the number of moles of Q given are 2 moles of Q are given. So it will be 2 divided by total number of moles. Total number of moles indicates moles of Q plus the moles of P, that is 3 plus 2, that will be equal to 5, into P naught of Q, that is vapor pressure of Q in its pure form, and vapor pressure of Q in its pure form is 60, plus mole fraction of P. Mole fraction of P is moles of P divided by total number of moles. So moles of P given is 3 divided by total number of moles is 5 into vapor pressure of P in its pure form, which is equal to 80. This will be 12. This will be equal to 16. So this will be equal to 24 plus 48. That will be equal to 72. Hence, option A is the right answer. Solutions can be classified into ideal solutions and non-ideal solutions depending upon whether they obey Rod's law or whether they do not obey Rod's law. Ideal solutions obey Rod's law at all conditions of concentration and temperature, whereas non-ideal solutions do not obey Rod's law at all conditions of temperature and concentrations. There are no such solutions which are completely ideal. But there are some solutions in which the solvent-solvent and solute-solvent interactions are same, which behave nearly ideal. Ideal solutions obey Rod's law at all concentrations, at all conditions of concentration and temperature. Consider a solution containing two components A and B. For ideal solutions, the AB interactions will be of same magnitude as present in the pure component AA and BB. Then those solutions are referred as ideal. Whereas in the case of non-ideal solutions, the AB interactions will not be of the same magnitude as present in the pure component AA and BB. So these are the following characteristics of ideal solutions. For ideal solution, delta H will be equal to 0 and delta V will be equal to 0. That is, no heat is absorbed or liberated on mixing the two components, and there will be no change in volume also. Whereas in the case of ideal, so non-ideal solutions, delta H will not be equal to 0. That is, on mixing, either heat will be liberated or absorbed, and there will be a change in volume on mixing. Non-ideal solutions can be grouped into two types. Non-ideal solutions that show positive deviation from the Rod's law and non-ideal solutions that show negative deviation from the Rod's law. Non-ideal solutions showing positive deviations. Consider a solution prepared by combination of two components A and B. In a non-ideal solutions that show positive deviation, the interactions between the AB will be weaker as compared to AA and BB interactions. Since the interactions in the solution are weaker, the escaping tendency of the molecule increases, hence the vapor pressure also increases. Therefore, the observed vapor pressure will be greater than the vapor pressure predicted by the Rod's law. Since the interactions are weaker, the volume of the solution increases, so delta V will be greater than zero, that is, the total volume of the solution will be greater than the sum of volumes of the two components. And hence delta H, the enthalpy change also will be greater than zero, that it will be positive. Non-ideal solutions that show negative deviation. Here the AB interactions are stronger than AA and BB interactions. Since the interactions are stronger, the escaping tendency of the molecule decreases. As a result, the vapor pressure predicted, the vapor pressure, observed vapor pressure will be less than the vapor pressure predicted by the Raoult's law. Since the interactions are more, the volume of the solution decreases, hence delta H, delta V mixing will be less than zero, and delta H mixing also will be less than zero. Students, let's discuss the next question. The boiling point of an azeotropic mixture of water and ethanol is less than that of water and ethanol. The mixture shows no deviation from the Raoult's law, positive deviation from the Raoult's law, negative deviation from the Raoult's law, option D, that solution is unsaturated. The question indicates that a mixture of water and ethanol boils at a temperature lower than the boiling temperature of water and ethanol separately. The mixture boils at lower temperature indicates that the escaping tendency of the molecules after mixing has increased. If the escaping tendency of the molecule has increased indicates that the forces of attraction between water and ethanol have decreased. If the forces of attraction are of between water and ethanol are weaker, then the observed vapor pressure will be greater than the vapor pressure calculated from the Raoult's law. If the observed vapor pressure is greater, then the solution are said to show positive deviation from the Raoult's law. Hence, option B is the right answer. Colligative properties. Colligative properties are the properties of the dilute solution that depend upon the number of solute particle and not on the nature of the solute particle. We come across four colligative properties: osmotic pressure, relative lowering of vapor pressure, elevation in boiling point, and depression in freezing point. Colligative properties are directly proportional to the number of particles, that is directly proportional to the concentration. That is, as the number of particles or as the concentration increases, the colligative properties also increases. Equimolar solution of two different substances have same values of colligative properties provided the substances are non-volatile and non-electrolyte. Let us move with the first colligative property, that is osmotic pressure. Before moving on to the osmotic pressure, let us define what is osmosis. Osmosis is flow of solvent molecules from dilute solutions to a concentrated solution through a semi-permeable membrane. Then what is this osmotic pressure? Osmotic pressure is an external pressure that should be applied on the solution to stop the phenomenon of osmosis is called as osmotic pressure, and it is denoted by pi. Osmotic pressure is related to concentration as pi into V is equal to N into R into T, where pi is osmotic pressure, V the volume of the solution, N number of moles, R constant, and T is the temperature. Pi is equal to N by V R into T, where N by V, that is number of moles divided by volume, is nothing but the concentration. Hence, osmotic pressure is equal to CRT, that is concentration into constant, R into temperature. Friends, let's move on with the next question related to calculating the osmotic pressure. The osmotic pressure of a solution of 3.42 gram sugar whose molar mass is 342 in 500 ml of solution at 300 Kelvin will be. Your options are option A 0.246 atmosphere, option B 0.492 atmosphere, option C 2.46 atmosphere, and option D 4.92 atmosphere. Osmotic pressure is related to concentration as osmotic pressure pi is equal to C into R into T, where C is the molar concentration. But they have not mentioned the molar concentration, instead they have given you the mass, molar mass as well as volume. Hence concentration will be equal to N by V R into T, where N is the number of moles of the solute and V is the volume of the solution. Number of moles of solute is equal to weight of solute divided by the molecular mass of solute into volume V R into T. This will be equal to weight of the solute given is 3.42 gram divided by molar mass is 342 into volume 500 ml. We need to convert it into liters and then we need to substitute here. 500 ml corresponds to 0.5 liter into the value of R. R is equal to 0.0821 into temperature. Temperature is 300 Kelvin. If you calculate this, the value will be equal to 0.492 atmosphere. Hence, option B is the right answer. Let us discuss the next problem. 3% aqueous solution of urea is isotonic with 9% aqueous solution of organic solute B. The molar mass of B is option A 90, option B 45, option C 342, and option D 180. We'll see what are isotonic solutions. Two solutions are said to be isotonic if they exert same osmotic pressure. If the two solutions exert same osmotic pressure, then the osmotic pressure of one will be equal to the osmotic pressure of another. So I can write osmotic pressure of one, that is urea, is equal to the osmotic pressure of the solution which is prepared from solute B. If osmotic pressures are equal, then concentrations should be same, because osmotic pressure is a colligative property, and colligative properties, if they are same, then the concentrations should be same. Concentration same indicates the number of moles in one should be equal to the number of moles in another. That is, the number of moles of urea should be equal to the number of moles that are present in the solute B. Number of moles of urea is given by the formula weight of urea divided by molar mass of urea, represent W1 and M1. Number of moles of solute B is equal to weight of solute divided by molar mass of solute. We are supposed to calculate the molar mass of the solute. Weight of urea, 3% solution indicates 3 gram of urea divided by molar mass of urea is 60. That is equal to weight of solute B. 9% solution indicates 9 gram divided by the molecular weight. That is what we need to calculate. Hence, M2 will be equal to 9 into 60 divided by 3. 3 ones are, 3 threes are 18. So the answer will be equal to 180. Hence, option D is the right answer. Next question is, the osmotic pressure of a blood is 8.21 atmosphere at 37 degrees Celsius. How much glucose should be used per liter for an intravenous injection that is isotonic with blood? Options are 58 gram, option B 180 gram, option C 54 gram, and option D 8.21 gram. So in this question, we are supposed to calculate the mass of the glucose that is required to prepare a solution that should be isotonic with the blood, and osmotic pressure of the blood is given to be as 8.21 atmosphere. This indicates that osmotic pressure of the blood given should be equal to the osmotic pressure of the glucose solution that we prepare, that is equal to 8.21 atmosphere. We are supposed to calculate the mass of the glucose that is required so that the osmotic pressure becomes equal to 8.21 atmosphere. We know that osmotic pressure pi is equal to N into R into T divided by V. That is equal to, we are supposed to calculate the mass of the glucose. So number of moles can be written as weight of glucose divided by molecular mass of glucose into R into T divided by V. That will be equal to weight of the glucose is what we need to calculate. Osmotic pressure given is 8.21 atmosphere divided by molecular mass of glucose is 180 into R. The value of R is 0.0821 into temperature given is 37 degrees Celsius. That should be converted into Kelvin. That will be 273 plus 37. That will be equal to 310 Kelvin divided by volume. Volume of the solution is 1. So we require the weight of the solute. So weight of the glucose is equal to 8.21 into 180 into 1 divided by 0.0821 into 310. This will be equal to 58 gram. Hence, option A is the right answer.